Non-financial reporting is something which is coming up from last 3, 4, 5 years. It is catching up, say in last 3, 4 years. The phenomena was almost, I think, 8 to 10 years old, but from last 3, 4 years, it's in vogue. So from a career perspective also, one can see wherever you go in any organizations, this is the things which is coming up in a big way. Be it currently it is with the big organizations, but slowly and slowly it will you know, catch up with the mid-sized and small organizations also. So this will give you a brief on that how this reporting is done from non-financial aspects. But before that, I would like to take your opinion on say a term called sustainability. Again, this is somewhat related with the sustainability, so that's why I thought before getting into the reporting side, what is your take on report? Suppliers of a company, those people who are supplying, you know, certain raw materials or some inputs to the organizations would like to see financial reports. They are also stakeholders. Okay, but where it lacks. So these are the issues with the financial reporting. The issues was that it has a focus on limited stakeholders. Limited stakeholders means that whatever stakeholders we discuss, like employees or say investors or government or your trade institutions or any other suppliers, sometimes customers, they are broad stakeholders. But beyond that, there are more than these different stakeholders which also exist. But these financial reports does not look at those stakeholders' perspective. Like if I talk about the environment, of course, an environment and the citizen of the country. So they are somewhat associated with each other. So these financial reports does not talk about that. So it has a limited focus on limited stakeholders. Agreed? Then of course the social issues, like whether the company is following all the labor laws, labor practices, how company is using this part involved into corruption part. This you cannot see from financial report, which is a very, very important aspect. Okay, then environmental issues that somebody mentioned, human rights, and the product responsibilities. So these are some broad areas where the financial reporting does not talk about these broad areas. Okay. So then you have water, recycling of water. So you'll come to know the company will report about the recycling part of the water. So there are different indicators which are used. In this manner. Within the environment, again, like compliances, these are not the comprehensive indicators. I have covered few indicators which are shown here. Like for example, if EN29, I have missed certain indicators. So just a few indicators just I am just quoting here. Like in case of EN29, this talks about monetary value of significant fines and total number of non-monetary sanctions for non-compliance with environmental laws and regulations. So that has to be reported. Then there are certain things relating to supplier environmental assessments. How many times a supplier has been put on screening from the environmental criteria? So percentage of new suppliers that were screened using environmental criteria. So this is from suppliers environmental assessment side. So then you have a social. So many indicators are there, like subcategories we have mentioned, starting from the labor practices, decent work, human rights, society, product responsibilities. Then you have within the aspects different indicators. So which we should can see. So just I'm just going through quickly. Then you have social indicators, SO1, SO2, so you can find out this. Any idea? The reporting side, 80 odd companies. Worldwide, 3,000 odd companies have reported as of now by 2011-12. 13 data is not available right now. So, what as of now you have heard from a sustainability reporting side, the initiative of the Government of India. Any initiatives the Government of India has done, has taken, and the other stakeholders, what they are doing on that front.
So you need a resource is a problem, means funding is a problem.
Yeah, because for the smaller companies, it may be difficult to do the science reporting.
Okay. Generally the reporting cost varies from say around 1 crores to almost 20 crores in rupee terms. So within say if mid-sized organizations 1 crore rupees, 10 million. It will cost hardly around 10 million rupee, which is not a big amount for mid size. Of course, for small size, yes. For mid size and to large size organizations having say 100 crores plus turnover, it's not a big thing. And that too, when you know that the sustainability is a big issue, things are not going well from a broad perspective. And if financial reporting can be made mandatory, then why not this sustainability reporting? And of course, as far as the training aspects is concerned, that is an issue. We don't have a pool of trained people who can really generate reports. That is an issue. So, but that can be taken care of. To begin with, maybe initially if we can ask say top 500 listed companies to generate reports in the next say, 3-5 years, and thereafter moving to some B-grade companies, B-grade or say top 2000 companies later on, and say top 1000 companies which are listed one. So of course phased manner, this has to be done in a phased manner, but that is the need of an hour. You cannot really think beyond without this. So it is there, and that government has also sensed this. Government of India has also sensed this aspect that this is a key area, and that is an issue which needs to be addressed, and if it is addressed sooner, it is better. Okay. So what they are doing is that in 2011, in an annual economic survey, they have included a chapter called Financing of Climate Change. So that was a positive thing that the Government of India and their ministries were somewhat sensitive towards that aspect. Although the recent reports, if you must have gone through the yesterday's newspaper, did you check that? Where we stand in terms of environmental water pollution part? How much environmental damage is happening? And where we stand? 155.